This son of a Kentucky painter took up boxing after neighborhood bullies stole his bicycle. His trainer said the boy, then known as Cassius Clay, grew to mix raw talent with determination.
A dynamite right sends Archie Moore crashing to the floor.
In 1964, he shocked overwhelming favorite Sonny Liston to win his first world heavyweight title.
Short, choking right to the jaw, Liston goes down.
Washington Post newspaper sports columnist Mike Wise says the confident boxing great continued to dominate, fighting with both his fists.
These represent dynamite.
And his words.
He was probably the first guy, the first athlete in America to brag about something and back it up. Nobody boasted in those days.
I'm the greatest, and I'm knocking out all bones. And if you get too small, I'll knock you out.
Clay had joined the Nation of Islam and changed his name after that fight to one that is revered around the world, Muhammad Ali. 3 years later, he was vilified for refusing the U.S. Army draft based on his religious beliefs and his opposition to the Vietnam War. Ali was convicted of draft evasion and stripped of his title, keeping him out of the ring for 3 years until the Supreme Court overturned his conviction in 1970. Just months after returning to the ring, new heavyweight champ Joe Frazier dealt Ali his first professional loss. But Ali later took his revenge against Smoking Joe Frazier and won their second fight. Another classic bout for Ali was against George Foreman. Ali and Foreman took their 1974 championship fight to the former Zaire in a remote part of Central Africa. It was a boxing match immortalized as the Rumble in the Jungle.
I have wrestled with an alligator. I have tussled with a whale. I done handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. Bad, ain't it? Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick. Bad, fast.
And for him to employ what people think still to this day is one of the most amazing strategies, act like you're tired, let the big guy punch himself out, and then all of a sudden galvanize yourself and find a way to knock him out in the eighth round. Well, that was still probably the most triumphant moment in boxing history.
The great man has done it!
Ali then met Frazier in their third and final clash. It was late 1975 in the Philippines, dubbed the Thrilla in Manila. Ali endured 14 brutal rounds and emerged victorious. The boxing legend's later years were plagued by Parkinson's disease, which he was diagnosed with in 1984. He could no longer float like a butterfly or sting like a bee, but his generosity and passion for humanity continued to inspire people around the world.
Muhammad Ali was beloved. You know, there was a heart component that I don't think anybody will ever touch.
Whether loved or hated, Muhammad Ali certainly made people feel. And that, perhaps even more than his boxing prowess, will be his lasting legacy. Carla Babb, VOA News, Washington.
Here we go.
Okay, now.